It is the new model. The new model you love and crave. We love the new model. We love that it is new. Buying the new model will fix our life, at least for a little while. Then it is time to consume again. And the cycle continues on and on and on and on.
Hi, my name is Tyler. We live in a society, Russo. And today we're going to be painting the model that is new.
This is the new model. He's made of polystyrene and thus will outlive me. I am a tryhard who hates fun, so I decided to give this model a power claw because it's the only way he'll ever be used in a game. The first step is to clip off his hand, ensuring that he will be useless to collectors. The power claw I used is from the Meganobs box. I didn't have the heart to give him two kill saws. Also, it'll probably be illegal soon. I primed the model with an airbrush. I used, I think Vallejo? Yeah, Vallejo airbrush primer. It creates a much smoother finish than a rattle can, and it's also more consistent. And it feels much worse when you accidentally mix a bunch of flock into your paint while base coating later, and ruin all that smoothness forever. First step is to use an Army Painter Masterclass Miniature Dry Brush. Why, this isn't sponsored, why am I? I don't know why I'm saying it like that. To apply a bronze base coat of whatever brand of paint is willing to sponsor me. Don't worry about neatness here, just make sure all the metallic bits are pretty well covered. Leave a little bit of the black showing through, because it'll look nice later, but just to start, try and get a even but light coat on everything. Holy shit, look at all that dust flying off. Is that why the model has like weird little particles everywhere? I thought it was me from the base. God damn, is it really from that brush? What the fuck? I don't know what happened there. I don't know how I didn't notice that. I guess the brush is why, or maybe? We're gonna dry brush with plate mail. It's a good thing I shot this in 4K, because now you can see every little fucking dust particle of it. It's all over everything now. Why are there so many? I don't know what caused that. It's gotta be from the brush. Yeah, do this, but with a different brush. I don't know what happened with mine. I don't think it necessarily means these brushes are bad. I gotta look into that. I mean, it could be the paint I use and the fact that it's been becoming the texture of tar on a shelf for 3 years. I don't know. This is embarrassing. I don't know. What the fuck? Use a shot of the finished model again, just to assure you that I have some idea of what I'm doing to some capacity, and this model would not look like absolute dog shit when it's done. Here's a garage. He's not why you bought this box, but he comes with it for free, so we're gonna paint him anyways. Here's the free grot. I used the Elysian green to base coat the skin. It's a nice, mild, not that saturated, just a good old-fashioned green. It's green. I applied a few thin coats, both thin in the amount of paint that's going on, but also thin in how much water is applied to all of the skin. Being kind of careful not to cover the metal, but these are the early stages, so if you get a little bit on there, it's not a big deal. Just try and wipe it off before it dries. Here's our freshly painted lumpy base coat. If you noticed areas later that you missed or weren't fully opaque, just keep going over it until they're base coated. For the middle areas, you want a little bit of the primer still showing through, but for the skin, in this instance at least, you want it fully covered. Here's me doing the same thing to the garage. There's nothing new to explain here, but I shot this footage, so I'm gonna use it. It's the brown goop we love to overuse. It's Reiklin Flesh Shade. No need to go hog wild, just a little in the cracks will do. You can also water it down slightly if that's your personal preference. And I did the same thing to all the metallic areas just to give them some color. Repeat the same steps to your grot out of frame. Can you guess what we're about to paint with the color leather brown? Fur, actually. I guess we're painting fur. I forgot. I thought it was leather. I used Mephiston Red to base coat the little sash thing that he's got wrapped dad style around his waist. Just like the skin, you want it fully covered. You don't want it translucent at all, and you want to do a few thin coats so it doesn't turn out lumpy. I like to paint the smaller metal pieces on Orc's prongs so that they stand out from the larger shapes that they're next to, like these little rings here. You don't want them to blend in with the shoulder pad. Next, they use Ushap Debone to base coat something, probably. The teeth. It's the teeth, everyone. Big reveal. We base coat the teeth. Any other teeth or bone-like surfaces. Next up, I used Army Painter Oak Brown, a brand whose name I promised to never publicly criticize or disparage if they pay me to do so. I mixed it with a little black and put a very light coat on a lot of the little detail areas. Next up, I used Vallejo Blue Green, a company who might be better or worse than Army Painter. Who's to say? I am a faithless mercenary. Also Vallejo Turquoise, but next time could be your company's turquoise. Who knows? I wanted to be able to say that he's a Death Skull's knob while still being able to look narrative players in the eye, so that's why we painted this skull blue. I highlighted all of the black areas with a one-to-one mix of black and Vallejo problematic gray. It's a good gray, I'm sorry. This is what Korzag looked like at this point. We've got most of our base coats done, and this is also right around the time where I forgot about Nikit and didn't paint him until the very end. I touched up all the leather areas of black, as well as the cables on the power claw, and he's finally completely base coated. Base coating is usually like one of the most time-consuming parts, even though it's also one of the least skill-dependent, but making sure your base coat is good is very important, and it'll make the next steps to come much, much easier. Before moving on to any details that are too precious, I wanted to get the base mostly out of the way. Painting the base is pretty messy, so it's nice to do before you have a bunch of details you spent a very long time on that you're afraid of accidentally getting brown on. After that was dry, I dry brushed with just the Mezzy Desert on top. And after that, I mixed in a little Wraith Bone and kept adding more and more Wraith Bone into the mix until I got a color that I was happy with. Finally, I added some selective highlights of just Wraith Bone on top of the rocks and the areas I wanted to bring more attention to. Then it was time to draw on all of our shadows and Reikland Flesh Shade once again. Irex Earth Shade is good here too if you want to go. Gay Hyena Gold. I can go wherever you want. Now is a good time to make the pants too bright. Then immediately make them darker. I don't know what I'm doing here. Oh yeah, highlighting the skin. I mixed an Ogryn Camo with the same green that we used earlier, Elysian Green, in a one-to-one mix. Continued to blend and make that brighter with more and more Ogryn Camo mixed into my palette using volumetric lighting. So line highlighting is what a lot of the models in GW box art have. It's where you just like outline the contours of the model. And the method of highlighting I'm using here is more focusing on like volume and creating little gradients throughout the model instead of just trying to like trace the edges. They're both perfectly valid approaches to highlighting. It's just the stylistic preference, and for this guy I wanted to do more volumetric highlighting. They're not mutually exclusive though. As you'll see later, I've got a bunch of line highlighting on the armor too and other little details. To know where to put the Ogryn Camo, I imagine that there was a light coming down from above, and where the shadows would be from that light, I applied a mix of these two. For the highlight areas, I tried to paint as much as I could while the paint was still wet to get smoother blend transitions. But for any areas I thought weren't smooth enough, I painted several very watered down, very thin coats on top. And if you repeat this enough times, you'll eventually get a pretty smooth gradient. Another thing you could do is, I think it's called a retardant. It's this medium that slows down paint drying time. A bunch of different companies make it. I know a lot of people who use the Vallejo one. I don't have any right now. Otherwise, I would have used it for this model too. And yeah, I repeated the exact same thing that I just described on the highlights for the shadows, and eventually I got something like this. Mixing the brown tones in helps a lot. It makes the skin look a little bit more natural. I feel if I use just dark green, I don't like how it looks as much. For some very fine highlights towards the end, I mix some Kislev Flesh into with the Ogryn Camo. Like the brown, just having a desaturated skin tone in there makes a more realistic looking effect. It makes it feel more like natural translucent skin. Pink can be a good color to mix in here too. And I made the face extra bright because I wanted it to be the focal point of the model that the eye's attention is drawn to when you first look at it. And if you want smoother transitions, like I said earlier, just keep adding it and watering it down a little bit and mixing on top. Here I'm also putting some small dots for highlights just to show where the light would be extra shiny. He looks like he's like from like Man of War or something. He looks like he's a bodybuilder covered in oil. This is a pretty shiny look, but I'm into it. And again, yeah, just keep doing the same thing over and over again until you get a result you're happy with. It really just does take like time and repetition, I feel, to make these transitions look good. Dude, the more I think about it, I'm so pissed about those little chunks that ended up in his skin. He was so clean when you look at that prime shot, and just look at it now. At least my man's back still be shiny as hell. For the teeth, I had the same approach to highlighting, except I use white for the very top, you shop the bone in between, and then some unnamed brown color that I forget for the recesses. And I glazed his lip with just the tiniest bit of pink, mixing with a little bit of flesh tone. Same approach to highlighting for his little dad sash, bright red mixed with Mephiston red. I feel like I'm almost done with him, but I still have like 40 minutes of unedited footage. I don't know, what am I doing for the rest of this video? I guess we get to find out together, viewer. I'm going back over with the bright red by itself. No dark red mixed in this time. Just keep on layering on. I went over all the dark areas that had recesses with Agrax Earth Shade. Right now I'm doing it on his, I forgot what a shirt was called.
But also the sash, the power claw, those little scratches, sure, why not? Everywhere, just about everywhere. I basically go to this cool leather daddy back patch with gray and blended it in the same way that I did the skin, just mixing the two together to make a gradient and trying to paint while it's still wet to create a smooth finish. And yeah, like the skin, be patient, go over it multiple times if you need to, and eventually I did a small edge highlight of basically pure white around all the points of interest, so the outline of the eyes, contour of the nose, and then the overall silhouette too, outlined with white. Here's a quick overall work in progress shot of him at this point. Yeah, he's starting to get there. Oh, huh, I guess I shot the same thing twice, but with better lighting and a turntable. I guess, yeah, I'll still keep the first section. It's nice. Who doesn't like looking at this boy? Hopefully not you if you're 10 minutes into the video. I did the same method of doing shadows and blending as I did for the rest of the model on the metallic surfaces too. Here I'm very out of focus, but what I'm doing is I'm adding some black into the shadows just to make them have more contrast, and I'm using I think Ironbreaker? Blood Belcher, the other old world name, that's what it's called. Did a very careful overbrush of light brown onto the fur areas to start to highlight them. And I did the same thing with the smaller brush for all the leather areas that I wanted to be brighter. I highlighted the jacket with a final touch of gray mixed with a tiny bit of white. You really don't want to make it too bright. I painted his eye at the worst possible camera angle. I didn't notice this while filming. Jesus Christ. Yeah, it's Mephiston Red watered down though. I'm trying to create like a big shadow around the eye of Mephiston Red too. You'll see it eventually when there's a camera angle. But now the model's not even here. Where'd he go? Oh look, he's back. Yeah, after the Mephiston Red is dry, though, I did a tiny dot of a much brighter red, and within that a tiny dot of orange, and the smallest possible dot of yellow inside of that. And here's the end result from an angle where you can actually see. Decided I want slightly more red glow, so I took some very heavily watered down Mephiston Red and repeated the same process on the periphery of the eye. Just like the skin, doing this will ultimately make it look a little more blended. Does that look more blended? Yeah, I think it looks more blended. Good job. I highlighted the fur trim on the hat and his boots with what looks like you shot T-Bone. Here's a quick view of him from all angles just to see the progress we've done so far. Yep. I wanted to draw a checker pattern on his pants. I don't know if it's ever canonically explained why it works like checkers, but I think it's really cute that they do. So for all the works I give special attention to, I try and draw little checkers here and there. I'm using a Gundam marker. You could use a Micron pen or a fine tip Sharpie would work too. It just helps create a guide so that it's easier to fill in the squares with paint later. The guide doesn't have to be that neat. I messed up a little here, but the main point is just so that it helps us know where to paint. I usually start filling the guide in with white first, just because it's easier to paint black over white than it is white over black. And I should clarify, I'm not actually using pure white here. I'm just using a little bit of watered down Wraithbone. Pure white's too bright. On this model, I think it'd be distracting. Pretty hard to get the pattern completely right the first time. So I just keep going over the checkers again and again until the pattern's at a place where I like. It doesn't have to be perfectly clean. I mean, orcs probably wouldn't paint theirs perfectly clean, so I don't think you have to paint their pants perfectly clean either. But yeah, just get it to a place where it looks good from far away. And I repeated the same process for the top of the power claw, just to have something interesting to look at, because most of the time when he's on the battlefield, you're not going to see the pants that much, just like they're like covered by his torso. But yeah, from a top down, the power claw would be very clear while playing. I applied two thin coats of black to the base rim. Make sure you paint your base rim, please, otherwise I'll have anxiety the whole time I look at your model. For some finishing touches, I used some enamel paint to add rust effects to the metal areas. The next step is to remember that this box comes with two models. Paint Nikit the same way you painted Gorzag, but with half the enthusiasm. And that's it. That's Gorzag Git Stompa. If you enjoyed this video, I would appreciate a like, a comment, and or a subscription. I also have a Patreon, the link to which will be in the video description below. We also have an extremely active Discord server. If you're on Discord or you want to join Discord, I'll have a link to that too. Today's model is provided by Jeremy, the champion of Halloween. He goes by Anime Clown on our Discord server, and he bought this for me, and it was a very kind gift. Thank you, Jeremy. He has a D&D Twitch channel with his friends that I'll put in the video description below. If you'd like to buy something for the channel, I'll have a link to a wish list in the video description too. Models aren't cheap, and if you want to get something, I'd really appreciate it. All the music in today's episode was by the band Health. They're great. At least one of them plays Warhammer. They might all, I don't know. I've listened to them for a long time. I'm sure they don't need much help with promotion from me, but I'll put a link to them below too. I hope you had fun. I'm eating snack mix. Goodbye for now.